Okay.
Right back.
Alright.
See you later.
See ya.
Okay, so we're all getting ready to go to my brother's graduation ceremony because he's graduating today. So today's gonna be kind of an exciting day. And, you know, I'm just dressing all fancy and I'm still not ready, but, you know, I'm gonna meet them over there and, yeah, I'm still getting ready. Okay, now that we're ready, we're heading over to my brother's graduation ceremony. Yes. Just waiting for my parents.
Oh my God.
Okay, so Dad, what do you think about Fede graduating?
Oh man, I'm so excited. I can't believe it.
You can't wait to see that?
Of course. I'm ready for it.
Oh,
I'm so nervous.
Oh yeah.
Oh Fede. I'm very proud of you.
Okay, so we're ready in this place for my brother's graduation. He came here early, so we don't know where he is exactly.
There's no space downstairs, so we need to go upstairs.
Better view. It's a way better view.
Hey guys.
Oh my gosh.
We got the best seat in the house.
Yes, we're at the high levels.
We're in the second floor and we're like in the edge.
Yeah,
so
we're nearly by the edge and we can see a perfect view of Federico and the rest of the seniors.
This will be awesome.
This will be the best like senior graduation ever.
I know.
Like, I've been here like 2 years ago when my sister graduated with her friends.
Uh-huh.
And it was like just
and
brilliant.
Just imagine this. And 2 years from now, it's gonna be me that's over there.
Oh wait, you skipped me.
Huh?
Mine's is next year from now on. But like,
yeah, you're exactly.
Yeah, but like, I like the seniors this year and 2 years ago.
Yeah.
But my seniors, like, is meh, cause like, they could behave so like, don't get me wrong, I have good friends. Like, most notably the ESO kids.
Mm-hmm.
Because they behave well, unlike the majority of them, they like, they could be immature at times or so.
Somebody's there.
So yeah.
We got a lot of people down here.
Jimmy.
Hey. Oh my God.
Hey.
Oh my God. So my parents are like right over there.
Yep.
And yeah, we already saw a couple of teachers here. You know,
just a few like.
And like security guard people.
Like 2 years ago, I saw like all the teachers that were in Matter Academy
mm-hmm.
were sitting like over there while the seniors, well, there were more chairs last year. Oh, there's like over, you know, like 32 seats.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think that's for the seniors. I think the teachers are standing up or something. Oh wait, my mistake. The teachers sit at those chairs while the seniors sit in the first four rows of the seat, most notably in the middle area.
Yeah.
Wait,
Guitar dude, yeah. Mr. Ball! See Kristen and Alexandra. There goes Bianca.
Staff, family, friends, and fellow graduates. We stand United States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please remain standing for our national anthem presented by Ms. Charlene Bassett.
Oh, say, can you see?
Members of the Governing Board, Mr. There are so many others that share their invaluable skills with all of us that we know for a fact can be applied to the real world. From all of these years in high school, we can take one definitive lesson with us. Despite all the obstacles that we may face, we must continue and not give up. As Bill Gates once said, if you think your teacher is tough, wait until you get a boss. And your schools may have done away with winners and losers, but life has not. In some schools, they have abolished failing grades, and they'll give you as many times as you want to get the right answer. This doesn't mean to slayers, because that means to anything in real life. Hang in there, guys, because if you think the real world is tough and are afraid of losing your friends, we can always count on Facebook and Google Plus. Good luck, class of 2012.
Remember that the harder you work, the less you work, and that a touch You ever remember how important this is to be a good friend. I love you all, and I wish you all the best of love in future endeavors. And of course, YOLO. Omar Mitchell, Superintendent Diploma of Distinction, Summa Cum Laude, attending Florida International University. Woo! Yasmin Wong, Superintendent Diploma of Distinction, Summa Cum Laude, attending Miami Dade. Monica Giselle Cisneros, Superintendent Diploma of Distinction, Summa Cum Laude, attending University of Colorado. Danielle Jesse
applause for them.
Thank you.
told me it was a school in a tough neighborhood. A school in an area of low performing public schools where everybody was below the reading level in FCAT and other assessments. And why would I want to work there? Who cares what that place is? And I remember that night I spoke to my grandmother about this opportunity and the challenges of opening a new school and what lies ahead. When I told her where the building was located, she asked me to take her to the school. And as every Cuban grandson does, I listened to her. And I drove her to Manor Academy East. And I'll never forget passing 10th Avenue and 4th Street by Tony Tire and the little pizza place. And she was teary-eyed. And I said, abuela, ¿qué pasó? So she says, when they arrived from Cuba many years ago, they experienced very difficult times. She continued to speak of sacrifices they made to allow my mother and her siblings to go to school, and she told me how saddened she was when her daughters, one of which was a pre-med student, had to drop out of the university to find a job to make ends meet. They lived on 10th and 4th right across from the Tony Tire place. My grandmother recognized many of the buildings and stores, and at that point her tone changed as she began to speak about the lives of her children and how her 12 grandchildren are all grown professionals who have given her 7 great-grandchildren. How they brighten her life each and every day. Why that's important to me is because at that moment, with my grandmother, I knew Manor East was the right place for me. I am the second person in my family to earn a college degree. My brother is the first because he's older and beat me to it. I am also the first person to earn a master's degree because I figured I'd beat him to that much. So I did. I know that many of the graduates here tonight will be the first in their families to do the same. I know the difficult times that lie ahead for each of them as they encounter uncharted waters they must navigate through in the years to come. But I also know the sacrifices they must make to accomplish their goals. I was one of you. We do have a lot in common, more than you think, seniors. You are the first class to make it through this entire high school experience at Manor Academy East. As the faculty and administration put together the pieces of this puzzle, you were there every step of the way. Your continued strive for excellence kept us wanting to give you more and create more programs for you to benefit from. For the past 4 years, we have added more courses to the curriculum because you demanded them. Because of your leadership, we can boast about some numbers. For example, there's 322 students in this high school. 193 of them are enrolled in advanced placement courses. That's 60% of the student body. In other words, 60% of those students who are enrolled in those courses also pass their AP exams. So congratulations to you. Our first graduating class had only 5% of the seniors attending a 4-year university. It was a small class of about 37 students. Last year, the seniors, 25 of them, were accepted to 4-year universities. This class continues to raise the bar as 32% of the seniors have been accepted to a 4-year college or university. Congratulations. We continue to set examples and raise the bar in other areas as well. Last year's seniors, they earned $376,000 in scholarship money. The class of 2012 earned over $450,000 in scholarship money for their tuitions.
Yeah. Hopefully increase more.
And the list of colleges and universities include Florida International, Florida Atlantic, Florida Gulf Coast, Barry, Nova Southeastern, St. Thomas University, Catawba College in North Carolina, Hofstra University in New York, the University of Colorado, and of course, Stephanie Duke University. Another area in which the class has excelled is that of establishing tradition at a complete high school. and made it to the regional quarterfinals. This team has a leader named Daniel Echevarria. Daniel participated in flag football, basketball, and baseball, and he was a team captain in each sport. He will be playing baseball tomorrow, representing Miami-Dade County Public Schools against the Broward County All-Star team. He led the baseball team to a 13-3 record. I'm not done, this one's kind of long, he's good. To a 13-3 record. He was the team's MVP and named Player of the Year in District 2A in Miami-Dade County. He will represent us proudly next year at Florida Gulf Coast University. Team also won first place in the respective competition. We beat a sister school, their sister because we beat them at Matter County. Seniors like Mario and Emerson Fiddle are champions and leaders on the team as well. Women's basketball team. Remember the first year we were here and I drove you in my car to Orlando? Coach Fernandez and Delgado for that. And Mr. Frawley for that basketball tournament. And we've come a long way. We made it to the District 2A semifinals. We were led by six seniors, Jason Simmons, Gus Fiallo. Those two students just returned from a recruiting trip in Georgia where NCAA scouts and recruiters were evaluating their talents for scholarships. The team captain is senior Chris Laviosa, Daniel Echevarria, he also led the team in rebounds, and MVP of the team, Rafael Barbosa. However, the most impressive line item in the senior class is a part of something that is especially rewarding, I think, to all of us. This senior class was awarded a silver medal by Newsweek and World Report as one of the top high schools in the nation in preparing students for higher level education. Matter Academies was ranked the 43rd best high school in the state of Florida and the 71st top charter school in the nation by this well-regarded and respected publication. What a difference 4 years can make, especially when we're blessed with leaders like yourselves. You stole my thunder a little bit, but what a difference in character and the development of young adults that we've witnessed here. These accomplishments should make you all proud. With accomplishments like these, you certainly can look the other way when a chicken appears in the hallways or bathroom. Because of all of you and your motto, YOLO just means something totally different. See, please rise. Congratulations, class of 20.
Quest for knowledge never cease to honor always and at ease.